Right, so in my previous tutorial, I taught you how to set up and use Llama 3.1 for free. Yes, absolutely free, because the model is what? Free. In this tutorial, we are taking things one step ahead. I am coming to teach you how to set up and use Llama 3.1 together with LangChain for free. Okay, so the question will be, why LangChain? Alright, so LangChain is a framework that allows you to build a lot of projects around large language models. Okay, so you can build chatbots with LangChain, which I've also built some on this channel with you guys. There are ton of projects which you can also build with LangChain. So knowing how to connect open source and free models with LangChain is something you have to have in your bucket list. So in this tutorial, I'm going to take you through how you can set it up for free and start using Llama 3.1 with LangChain. Ready to do it? Let's get right into it. So let's get started and see how we can set this up together. Before we get started, we first need to get API key. So Llama 3.1 API key. And in my previous tutorial, which is somewhere here, I taught you how to do that. I taught you how to get this API key. But I'm just going to take you real quick how to get the API key from the Grok AI platform. So just open up your browser and search for Grok AI. So grokai.com. And when you open grokai.com, over here, you can start even testing Llama 3.1 or any of their models for free. But as developers, as usual, we want to test things in code. Okay, so all you need to click on is click on start building. And this will take you to their playground where you can get access to API and start building with Llama 3.1. I've taught all of this in my previous tutorial, which the link is also in the description. Alright, so over here, all we need is to get our API key, okay? So you click on API keys, and I've created some couple of them, but I'm going to create a new one, and it's free, so don't worry, you're not going to pay a penny for this. Nothing, you just use it free. And one advantage or one thing I like about it most is very fast. The inference speed is insane, and you see that when we are testing it, okay? It's very great, okay? So, I'll hit on create API key and I'll call this API key subscribe. So if you are watching this tutorial up to this point, kindly subscribe and also share. Do me a favor by doing that. It's not mandatory though, but just help me by subscribing and sharing my content. Thanks a lot. All right, so I'll click on submit. And this will generate the API key for me. So I'll just copy it and click on done. And this is all we have to do over here. All right. So I'll open Visual Studio Code and I'll create a new file and I'll call this file .env, all right? And over here, I'll just type key. And this is equal to the API key I've created. So I'll save this and I'll close my env file. The next thing I'll do is to create a new Python file and I'll just call this main.py and I'll hit enter and that's it. Alright, so now we need to install LangChain and also install LangChain Grok in order to connect the Llama model together with what? LangChain. Alright, so these are the requirements. We need to install LangChain Grok and LangChain as well. So on Windows, I'll press Ctrl plus backtick and this will pull up my terminal. But as usual, if you are on Mac, you are on other operating system, you can just click on these three dots and open your terminal. That also works. From here, I have to install all the packages in the requirement.txt file. So I'll just do pip install requirement.txt. But before I do that, I've created a virtual environment, so I have to activate it. So I'll quickly do that. Alright, so after activating it, now I can just do pip install requirement. So before requirement, I can do hyphen R and then I can type requirement.txt. All right, so I have already installed this library. So you can see it has just run quickly and told me my requirements are already satisfied. In your case, it wouldn't be the same. It will take some time and install these libraries for you. So after installation, I'll just clear this terminal and now we are ready to write some code. Alright, so in my main.py file, I'll do some couple of imports. I'll first import OS and I'll also import .env or .load.env. So from .env, I'm importing load.env. Okay, so this will help us to get our API key, and quickly I'm just going to get that. So I'll write key is equal to os.getenv or getenv, and inside here I'll just type the name I've given to my API key, which is key right here. Alright, so I'll just type in key here and this will load up my API key for me. But before you can able to even get this API key, you have to what instantiate the load.env here. And this is what will load up all the API keys you have in the .env file, and you can get access to them in your code. Alright, to test that this is working, I can go ahead and print the key to see if I'm going to get my API key. But you don't actually have to leave this after testing, because it will expose your API key for others in your terminal. Alright, so everything works, and you can see right here I'm getting my API key and it's the same. So guys, disclaimer, right after this tutorial I'm going to revoke this API key, so just don't try to use it, because you can create it for free. It's absolutely free. Just log in with Grok AI and then you can create your own API key. If you can't do that, I've done a tutorial on that, so the link is also in the description. Alright, so it's loading in the right way, so I'll clear this and now continue to do some couple of imports. Okay, from LangChain underscore Grok, I'm coming to import chat Grok, and from here I'll do one import. But let's go ahead and test this model before we do that import. All right so now we have our API key, we have also imported our chat Grok. Let me close up the terminal so that I get to see our coding environment, our IDE. So from here I can instantiate our model, and then I can say model here is equal to our chat Grok. All right so this chat Grok accepts a couple of parameters we need to give to it. One is your API key and your model. Okay, so for the API key we already have it, so I can just type here API key, and this is equal to our key. Now the next thing is our model. Okay, so you need to also give it the model you want to use. Okay, so for that I'll do model here, and this model is equal to the Llama 3.1 model. So we have to go back to this particular platform, Grok AI, and over here go to their playground, and on their playground you can see they have a lot of models here you can choose from. But this tutorial is based on Llama 3.1, so we are going to choose Llama 3.1 70 billion parameters. All right so you can see it right here, so you can just write this Llama 3.1. Hyphen 70 billion hyphen versatile. Okay, so this is the model we are coming to use, and to do it I'm very lazy, so you can also click on view code here and you can just see the model name here. So you can see model is equal to, and I'll just copy the name here and paste it in my IDE. If you want to use any of the other models, it's the same process. So you can see we have the model here, and in my chat Grok I can go and do model is equal to, and the model I've what just instantiated. Alright, so this is it. This is how we can now set up this model, and these are the parameters it accepts. You can also give it a temperature value, and this temperature value shows how creative it will be. So generally start from 0 to 1. Okay, so you can just tweak it between 0 to 1 if the model is not performing right. So you can specify temperature and you will give it a value. So for now you can put it at 0 to see how the model behaves, and you can tweak it later. All right so these are all the parameters the chat Grok will take, and then from here you can use this particular model. Okay, so we can just do, let's print it, and we can do model.invoke, and right here we can pass in some string, we can pass in some question, we can pass in something we want this model to do for us. So I will just do hello. I think hello world is nice, and let's see if this model is able to generate us a response. So if everything works right, this should give us a response. All right so let's save this and run the code. I'll raise the terminal for you guys so that we see whatever will go on. All right so you can see this generated a response for us, and we have content here which is hello, it's nice to meet you, is there something I can help you with, it will be will you like to chat, and so on. So we got a response with some other things we don't need, the token usage, the completion, and whatever things that has been returned. So we don't need those other things. All we need is the response. So we have to find our way out using LangChain to get only the response. So that's where the idea of what string output passes come in. So with string output passes, you can pass in this your string, and then you'll be able to get only the string output, or you can only to get the content from your large language models when you are using LangChain. So for that, I will import that from LangChain. So we do from LangChain underscore core dot output passes. We are coming to import string output passes or string output parser. Once we get this parser, we can instantiate the parser also right here. So we'll do our parser is equal to our string output parser. All right. So how this parser work is that the model passing whatever responses gets into the parser, and the parser will extract only the string or only your content for you. And that's what you need in any application you'll be building. So right here, before we use this model to invoke, we'll change this model, and we have to do it this way. We have to pass everything we are getting into the parser. So I'll call it LLM, which is a good name for the model, and this will be equal to our model. And over here, we have to connect it with our parser. So we use the pipe to do that. So over here, then we write what parser, and that's it. So now to get access to this model, or to use this model, we have to be using what LLM and not model anymore. So I can now do LLM.invoke instead of model.invoke. And now let's test this out. And here we go, guys. So you can see now, instead of getting a lot of other things, you are only getting the content, which is hello, it's nice to meet you, is there something I can help you with, or will you like to chat? So you can see this works great, and this is how insanely fast the Grok platform helps you to accelerate your models. Okay, so it's accelerating the Llama model so fast that when you just run it right there, you will get a response. It doesn't take a long time like some of the OpenAI GPT models or some of these platforms that gives you access to API. So it's very fast, and that's what I like most about that particular platform. All right, so I'll clear this, and that's it. That's how simple you can set up the Llama 3.1 model with LangChain. So you can see how easy it is. Okay, so now that you have this LLM, you can read in some files and tell this LLM to summarize it. You can do whatever you want. Instead of printing this, you can put this in maybe your result, and this will be equal to LLM.invoke, and you can now put in something you want this model to do for you here. So you can read in the data from a file and pass in that data here and tell this model to summarize it for you, to do anything with it for you. So guys, this is all I have in this tutorial. I'm just urging you guys to subscribe, also support this channel, share with people so that we build this community together. You can join our Discord server, join my WhatsApp community. The links are in the description, so that when you have any questions, you can put it out there. And there are a lot of experts, ton of experts there who can answer you. I'm also right there. I can answer you and also give you some more context about whatever you are asking. Thank you guys for watching, and I will see you in an upcoming tutorial.